Assalamualaikum everyone. Today I have developed the program of palletizer. This is the factory you see now palletizer, and here I have the program of palletizer. It took me almost 2 days to develop the program, so I will try my best to explain the things that are need to be explained, and I will provide you guys the program, and the link will be in my description box. So let's go to factory scene first. Here are the switches that are going to control this system. This is my start button. So you have to put the system in auto mode first. Set the system in auto mode, then press the reset switch, and then press the start button. So if you press the start button now, the system will start to run. So if you want to stop or pause the system in any situation, you can do that just by pressing this switch. So again, if you press this switch, the system will start to run from where you left off. So press this switch, the system will again start to run from that situation. And if you press this switch, the system will reset again. So you can see that the counter that is counter or the display that is showing the boxes that are moving from the conveyor to the pallet. That are shown on this display, but the display hasn't reset when I press the reset switch. So this will be done by the start switch. Put the system in auto mode and press the start button, the counter will reset. And here I have a knob and another display. This is for fix the set for the boxes. And what do I mean by set? Each set will have 6 boxes. So if you suppose if you set or fix 2 for 2, that means 2 set will move from the conveyor to the pallet, and each set will have 6 boxes. So 2 into 6, that means 12 boxes will move from the conveyor to the pallet. So I want to reset the system again. Just put the system in auto mode, reset the system, fix the set. I want to set it up to 2 to save the time. You can set it up to 5, not more than 5. But you can do the changes in the program in network 15. If you do changes here, 0.0 to 5.0, so you cannot cross the limit of 5. So if you put 10 here, so then you can set up to 10. So you can send 10 set of boxes at a time from conveyor to the pallet. So here I have designed it up to 5. So you cannot put here 1. If you want to send only 1 set, the system will give you some error. So you have to set more than 1, and you can set it up to 5. So I am setting it up to 2. Put the system in auto mode, then reset the system, and then press the start button again. So the boxes are started to come on the elevator, and 6 boxes will move at a time from the from this place to the pallet. So which one is the pallet? So the conveyor that is below, this is the conveyor. This is the conveyor that is moving or sending the pallets to the elevator. So here this chain transfer. This is the chain transfer that has brought the pallet here. And this is kind of an elevator, and this wooden box is the pallet. So 6 box are moving at a time. So 6 boxes make 1 set. So 12 boxes are moving at a time, and after the 2 set or the 12 boxes, the elevator has come down. And my system is working slow. That is why. This pallet has come a little bit further. So I will show you guys again. let's reset the system. My PC configuration is not bad, but still I am having some trouble. So if you have a good configuration, then you won't be having this kind of situation. So let's reset the system. Let's reset the system and put the system in auto mode. Set two sets or fix two sets here. Two sets, then press the start button. So this chain transfer is taking in the pallets. This pallet has moved up, and six boxes make one set, and six boxes will come down on the pallet. So this is the six boxes which make one set, and this will go down on the pallet. So this is happening because of my PC configuration. This is working bit slower because of the factory IO and the screen recorder and other softwares that are working at the same time. So after having two sets, the first set has already gone down. This is the second set. After having two set, the pallet will come totally down and move to the exit conveyor. This is my exit conveyor. Okay, I had to interfere a bit to move the boxes on the exit conveyor. This is because of the configuration. Otherwise, I have run this program with the 5 set of boxes, 10 set of boxes. It hasn't any problem. So this is the program. So let's stop here. So let's go to the TIA V16 program. This is the program. The first network is to connect the TIA portal to the factory IO. This is the second network where I have done the program for the start switch. And if you press the start switch after putting the system in auto mode, then the whole system will start to run. This is just for to switch on or off the start light or the reset light. So all the mechanical parts which needed to be start immediately just by pressing the start switch have this two switches there. This auto switch and the start switch. So this whole network is for the pause switch, the red switches that I have shown. This is the red switch. This whole network three is for the stop switch. So fourth network is for the box feeder. This is my box feeder. This conveyor is the box feeder. And the network five is for the load belt. Which one is the load belt? This conveyor or this part is the load belt. So load belt and the box feeder has the same switches and same logics. So what you can do is you can also make another branch and put the load belt here, so and it will work fine as it is working now. So this is network 5 is for the load conveyor or the load belt. Next I have the push limit. This one is for the this part. Let me show you. So this one is the push. This one is the push or pusher, whatever it is. This is the part that I have designed here. These are the logics that is for that pusher. And pallet feeder is the network below here. This is the pallet feeder. This is the pallet fitter that bringing the wooden pallets. So then I have the load pallet. This is the load pallet. This chain transfer is the load pallet. This is bringing the pallets up to the at the top of the conveyor. Then common for moving pallet fully down or up. So there is a situation that if this logic is active, then and only then you can move this elevator totally up or totally down. So here I have activated the move limit. Now if you press the elevator up, then whole chain transfer will move up. And here I have the elevator down. So if the move limit is not activated, and if you press the elevator down, or if you activate the elevator down, it will move by only one step. So let's again activate. So you can see that when the move limit is activated, then you can totally move up or down the chain transfer. Otherwise it will otherwise if you activate the elevator up or elevator down, it will move by one step. So that is, this part is for the move limit. If this is activated, then you can move the chain transfer totally up or totally down. This is for the clamp. The down part is below this network in network 13. This network is for elevator down. So elevator clamp is the, this is clamp, these are the clamps. When the boxes are moving here, the clamps are clamps are clamping the boxes together. So this is the clamp. Let me show you if I activate this one. So here you can see the clamp. These are the clamps that are going to clamp the boxes together. So this network 11 is for the clamp, and network 12 is for opening the plate. This is the plate of the elevator. If I activate this one, then you will get the then you can see that the pallet is opening. After opening the pallet, the boxes will move down. So network 12 is for opening the pallet. So this network is for turning the box 90 degree. So if I press the system, let's put the system in start mode. Set the limit up to 2. And then put the system in auto mode and press the start button. So if this one is activated, the boxes will move 90 degree. So if all the boxes have the same orientation, then there might be risk that the boxes might fall from the elevator, or when the chain transfer is moving down. If all the boxes have the same orientation, then the boxes might fall down from the conveyor. So that is why after the first set, this network will be activated, and the box will turn 90 degree. Each set will take 6 boxes at a time. So network 15 is what I have already shown, that network 15 is for fix the set for the boxes, and network 16 to stop or start the exit conveyor. Here this is my exit conveyor. This conveyor is the exit conveyor. the conveyor. This conveyor is the exit conveyor, and network 17 is for counting the total number of boxes that are moving from this conveyor to the pallet. This conveyor to the pallet. And last network 18 is for the warning light. This is just turning on or turning off the warning light. When the system will run, the warning light will work. So I couldn't explain all the switches because I have done this one by one, so I won't be able to explain everything properly. So that is why I didn't explain the switches, what are the logic that are working behind the working in every network. So that is why I am providing the program, so that you can check and analyze to understand. So the download link will be in my description box. So that is all from me today. I will see you guys with the new program in future. So thank you. Take care. Bye bye.